Hi everyone, it's Mr. Beasley here, doing our first online music video. Today's lesson for week one will be three sections: music theory, treble notes, treble clef notes, and speed quiz, music listening activity and video challenge, looking at instruments of the orchestra, and lastly, a music exploration task where we're going to look at a 10-mark question trying to describe a piece of music using music vocabulary. The resource I'm using today is also on the school website, and if you download the PDF, any of the links that I refer to can be clicked on. So for example, the BBC 10 pieces just says click here in the PDF. When you click on it, it opens up a browser, and there you can see that you can download this free ebook on iPad, Android, Kindle, so lots of options there. I've already downloaded it, but it is there for you to use. All right. So starting off today's lesson in our first section, looking at music theory, we're going to be looking at the notes of the treble clef, looking at identifying them, and also how to draw the treble clef. Now, musicians, they memorize these notes so that when they're playing along, they're not only knowing what note it is, but also their fingers can change that different pitch on their instruments. They can play really quick music at a really fast pace. So it's important that you know which line and which space is which note, and it's important that you start to memorize them. So today we're gonna have a quick video explaining face in the space and every green bus drives fast for the lines and the spaces of the treble clef, and then we're gonna do two quick quizzes to see if you can fill in all the notes. There's 60 notes on each quiz. See if you can do it in under 2 minutes. So let's start with that video. So in that video, they identified face in the space, and here they've got every good boy deserves football, but I prefer every green bus drives fast, non-gender specific. And here they've got middle C, and middle C is just underneath. So that's one extra note to add in. All right. So now's your chance. You've got your first worksheet here. You've got the notes of the treble clef. You've got the staff here, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F. The spaces are face, the lines, every green bus drives fast. And let's see if you can fill in all the notes. So if we start at the very beginning, we see that there's those five lines. I'll zoom in a little bit. And we see that the first one is on a line. It's the second line. And if we look at what the lines are, it's every green bus. So every green. The second line is a G. And the fourth line, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's a D. Every green bus drives. That's another D. Every green bus drives. This is on the line, every green bus. Here it's a space note, so it's face F, F-A-C, that's the third space, so C. So work your way through, you've got the reference on the side of the worksheet, and if you pause your video, then you will be able to give it a go before I go through the answers with you. So pause the video now. All right, let's have a look. Hopefully you've had a go at exercise 1 and 2. Let's go through those answers together. So starting at the very beginning, we've got G, A, B, D, F for face, then D, every green bus drives, B, F, C, A, and E. Going on to bar number 4, A, and G, bar 5, F, E, D, 6, G, D, C, bar 7, B, and F. Next line, bar 8, starts with an E. Then it's D, C, F, C, B. Bar 10 is an A, E. 11, A, B, E, and G. Bar 12, E, C, G, D, B, F. Bar 14, B, and A. Third line, bar 15. B, C, F, A, F, D, A, E, C, G. Bar 18, C, B, G, F, E. Bar 20 is A, E, D. Then bar 21, C, and G. So just refer to the bar number, check the notes. The note answers are underneath. All right, and for the second speed test, if you haven't done it already, you might want to pause the video again, see if you can get a little bit quicker at this one. Time yourself, see if you can do it in less time than it took you on the first speed test. It's a nice challenge for today. And just going through those notes, if you've already done the test. Starting in bar 1, you got an E, then G, F, A, F. Bar 2, A, G, E. Bar 3, F and B. 4, C, B, D, C, B. Bar 5 is a B and a D. 6, E. Bar 7, F and C. Second line, starting with the note E. For every, so every green, first line, second line, every green. So G, bar 9, A, 10, B and F, 11, C, E, D, F, D, bar 12, F, E, and C, 13, E and A, 14, A, G, B, A, G. Let's see here. A little bit of a typo there, well not typo, but editing. A, G. It wants to be difficult. There we go. And then the final line, G in bar 15. B, A, C, A. 16, C, B, G. 17, A and D. 18, E, D, F, E, D. 19, G and B. 20, C. 21, D and A. All right. Let's see how fast we can get at this over the next couple weeks. See if we can get so fast that you can be as quick as me, writing them in, typing them in. I think the quickest I've done it is 30 seconds. And that's just because it takes time to write them down, physically write the letters versus actually knowing what they are. All right, so that completes the first section, looking at the treble clef notes and doing a speed quiz. I mentioned about drawing those treble clefs. So on your exercise, you might want to actually put that symbol, the treble clef symbol, at the beginning, because your sheet, it doesn't have those treble clefs. So a way of drawing that treble clef symbol is you look at the 5 lines and you start by using the first and the third line. So there's 5 in total, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if we go with the first line, the first and third line, we do a backwards C. And it goes directly between the first and the third sign, or first and third line. All right, once you got that backwards C, You then turn it into the number 6, touching the fourth line up. So it goes up and makes a number 6. So backwards C into a 6 on the fourth line. All right, following that, you then make a loop and touch back at the fourth line. So loop up and touch back. And then from the loop up and touch back at the fourth line, you go straight down and hook left. So from the fourth line, straight down, hook left, and draw a dot, straight down, hook left. So if I wanted to do that all in one go, I've got the first and the third line marked out. Backward C, into a 6 at the fourth line, loop, straight down, hook left. Backward C, into a 6, loop down, straight down, hook left. And soon you're gonna become a treble clef pro. Be able to draw as many of those as possible. All right, good luck with that. Moving into the second part of our lesson today, the music listening and video challenge. So this resource that I had mentioned earlier from the BBC is fantastic, and it's a way for you to learn about the instruments of the orchestra, but also to identify them. So when you're listening to a piece of music, you know the difference between a flute, a trombone, or a French horn, and a violin. So if you've downloaded that app, it looks a little bit like this. And at the top of the ebook, there is a table of contents, and you can work your way through and look at the different instruments. So what I'd like you to do is spend some time using this app and learning about the different instruments from the different families, and also to memorize them. So if someone asked you name 4 brass instruments, you would say trumpet, French horn, trombone, and tuba. Or if you're asked to describe 5 woodwind instruments, you would know that they are flute, clarinet, oboe, saxophone, and bassoon. But also, if someone played them for you, you'd be able to identify them. So if we look on that app and we're here on the woodwind page, I can click through the different instruments. So flute, piccolo, which is another instrument, is a smaller flute, bassoon, clarinet, oboe, and on the app, when you turn the page, it goes through. I'm using the right arrow, so it goes through them all. If you want to learn a bit more, you can open up that video and learn more about each of them individually. And then if you go to this part, you can tap to play the game. So it'll play a sound, and you need to guess which instrument that is. So I know that's an oboe. Click on oboe, it says correct. Second sound, very high in pitch, so I'm gonna go for piccolo, correct. Sound 3, very low in pitch, and that's the bassoon. Sound 4. All right, I know that's the clarinet. Sounds quite deep and very mellow. And sound 5. The flute. So if you go through all the different instrument families and do this activity, then you'll be ready for our next task, which will be back in the presentation that's ready for you. So here we've got the instruments of the orchestra. Let's see here. All right. And what we want to do is we want to remember which ones belong with which. So if we start by drawing a line and the different voices, we on the handout there are 4 different voices and you want to connect them. So for example, soprano, tenor is also a voice, bass is a voice, and alto is a voice. Soprano is the high women's voice, alto is the low woman's voice, tenor is the high men's voice, and bass is the low men's voice. So for you now, if you go to woodwind, see if you can find which one is a woodwind out of these 3, and then connect it to the next line, to the next line, to the next line, and then do the brass, and then do the strings. So pause the video, work independently, see if you can get these ones right. All right, well, we're back. Let's see how you did. Woodwind, we've got the clarinet, flute, bassoon, and oboe. For the brass, we have trumpet, trombone, French horn, and tuba. And lastly, strings, double bass, viola, cello, and violin. Okay. So, let's do a final little quiz. You've got this handout here where there's 10 instruments. I'm gonna play a video or a sound clip. I wanna see if you can get these ones right. All right, are you ready for your quiz? Let's start. Here's your first instrument. What might this be? Number one again. Number two. Number two. Number three. Number three again. Number four. Number four. Number five. Number five. If you need more time, you can always pause the video and have a think. Refer back to your notes. Number six. Number six. Number seven. Number seven. Number eight. Number eight again. Number nine. Number nine again. And number 10. Number 10. So you can pause or rewind the video if you want to just hear those one more time. And then we'll go through the answers. All right, let's see how you did. So number one was the French horn. It is one of the higher brass instruments. But not the highest, the trumpet's the highest. Also, it kind of has a bit more of a muffled sound because it's pointing backwards when they play the French horn. So it has that bit more muffled sound. Number two, clarinet. Some say it's a bit of a woody sound. It is still higher in pitch. Number three, the cello. Now the cello is one of the deeper string instruments. Not quite as low as the double bass, but still quite deep in pitch. Dante, got a little friend here. He's trying to get involved. So I'm gonna just pick him up so he stops crying. All right, number four is the oboe. And it sounds a bit like a snake charmer, if you think about that. Number five is the viola. That's a tough one to hear, but it's a bit of a deeper violin. So think of a bit of a lower sound than the violin. But accidentally pushed clarinet there. All right, so number six is the bassoon. bassoon again is one of the deeper woodwind instruments, lower in pitch. Number 7, violin. The highest string instrument. Number 8, trumpet. And it's got a clearer sound than the French horn, a bit more direct, and it can go a lot higher than the French horn. Number 9, the flute. And number 10, the trombone. All right, so give yourself a score out of 10, see how many you got right. You could always do this quiz again another day and try and improve, or you can quiz yourself using the app that, or the ebook that you've downloaded. All right, so let's go into our final section of today's lesson. Let me just bring the screens back together. And the third and final part of today's session is music exploration, looking at a 10-mark question on sonority, tempo, and dynamics. So sonority is just a fancy way of saying the sounds you hear. If you heard a trumpet or a trombone, and you described what you heard, you're describing the sonority, you're describing the sound that is heard. The tempo and the dynamics, tempo being the speed of the music, and dynamics being the volume of the music. So we're going to listen to a piece of music, and we're going to see if we can describe it using these three categories. So is the tempo fast, medium, or slow? Is the dynamics loud, medium, or quiet? And the sonority, is it a brass instrument, a woodwind instrument, a string instrument, or perhaps a voice? Although we haven't spent much time on voices today, so it's one of the options, but we're going to focus mainly on the brass, woodwind, and string, or the instruments of the orchestra. So the piece that we're listening to today is On the Waterfront by Leonard Bernstein, and if you click on your downloaded file, you'll be able to go straight to this YouTube video. I've already got that preloaded for you, so let's have a listen. Thank you. All right, so we've just listened to it for the first time, and looking at the handout, there are two sections. There's from the beginning up to a minute and 30, and then a minute 30 till the end. And there's two distinct sections. The beginning is much different than the second half. So let's look at the tempo in the first half compared to the second, the dynamics, and the sonority. There's some fill in the blanks here, but also some listening. And if you watch along with the score, you'll start to see the names of the instruments in the music score happening too. So with the YouTube video look up, we've got 3 minutes and 32 seconds. If I just take it to the 1 minute 30 mark, and we play it there, you can see how all of a sudden the tempo gets to a different number. You can see some instruments that are coming in, other instruments that aren't playing, and we can kind of hear that stylistic change. Here's the name of an instrument. You see that's got a bit of a solo and it comes in, and that's a part of the answers we're looking for. So in the second half, the timpani drum starts, the cymbals come in doing lots of crash sounds, and then that solo instrument comes in third, something comes in fourth, then fifth, then the full orchestra. So have another listen again and see if you can watch along with the score, and starting at a minute 30, fill in those instruments in order. And then go back to the beginning and fill in the instruments in order that you hear at the start. So trombone's given for you, but what comes in first by itself? Then something in the trombone, followed by something in the harp at the same time, followed by the fourth instruments. They're in order of appearance. See if you can fill those in. Lastly, the dynamics. Are they loud, quiet, or medium in the first half? And then the dynamics build from what to what in the second half? And lastly, the tempo. Is the speed fast, medium, or slow in the first half, fast, medium, slow in the second half. So I'm going to pause you again, listen to that video one more time, refer back to the worksheet, and try and get your answers. All right, well, let's see how well you did. Let's see how that went. We've got a slow tempo in the first half, very slow to be honest, and then it starts to speed up and it gets much quicker in the second half, giving it a more aggressive feel. The first half is much quieter, the dynamics are softer, and they're more aggressive, and it builds. It builds from a medium loud to a very loud in the second half. And then lastly, our order of appearance, we go French horn, flute, trombone, then trombone, or trumpet and harp, followed by the clarinet. And the second half, the alto saxophone was what played that first little solo after the drums, followed by the trumpet, and then the full orchestra comes in for a very climactic, exciting end. All right, let's have a look at that, and let's listen to it at the same time. So that's the French horn. It's got that muffled sound. Flute and trombone. Still a soft dynamic, quiet. Trumpet. That's the harp. Bong. Trumpet. Dum. And our fifth instrument, coming in a moment, clarinet. Fast tempo, second half. Monty doesn't like that.
Alright, scary for you. Don't hide.
Alright, we'll stop it there. So, this piece kind of created a sense of a bleak city life and kind of an underlying mood of hostility and a feeling of danger. And I think it used tempo dynamics and sonority really effectively to create those feelings from that storyline. Did you agree? So, I hope you've enjoyed this week's first online music lesson. You can always pause, rewind, go back and do exercises again, make sure that's really clear. And I look forward to speaking to you next week. All the best. Goodbye.